Do you know that feeling when the answer is so easy and obvious you are convinced it must be wrong? Well, I think I've reached the pinnacle of that statement. So there is a game with a server with a skill that you can level up by chopping trees, and literally everyone hates it. The main reason for it is that you just don't have a choice. Well, supposedly. There are known to be three methods, but two of them are nothing but a desperate try to escape the only real option for the majority of people, which is to go to the public lobby and try to get from tree to tree as fast as possible while also dealing with the rest of the server trying to do the same exact thing, and trust me, it was annoying. Every time you saw others sweat in your lobby, you had two choices. Either you waste your time trying to compete with them, or you waste your time looking for another lobby. I'm sorry, but there are no winners in this game. And it's been going for years now. It must be like millions of hours of combined experiences, hundreds of tutorials, videos, stories. People are telling jokes, making memes, and it's funny because everyone knows it's true.
Foraging.
Easily the most difficult and annoying skill to master.
Nobody wants grind foraging because of the competitiveness.
This skill is absolutely atrocious.
Okay, so first of all, I'm genuinely sorry to hear about the years of painful experience you've been through, but why can't we just do this? Exactly. Okay, and just to be clear, I'm not trying to be mean. I'm genuinely sorry, and I'm genuinely looking for a reason why we just didn't do that for over a year now. But anyway, a few relevant informations first. In Hypixel, there is an axe that can break up to 35 connected logs with a single hit with a 2-second cooldown, except you can use monkey pad and reduce it to just 1 second. And with that in mind, we can easily calculate what is the highest possible efficiency. Well, I mean, the highest theoretical efficiency would be to just constantly breaking logs, but since, as far as I know, currently it isn't achievable as a viable method, using the ability on a big chunk of wood every time it's available, which is every second, is as close as you can get. And I know it may seem like 1 second isn't that much, especially in a situation when half of the time is already wasted on the reaction time, time to process information and make decision. But just get rid of that and you'd be surprised how much you can do in 1 second. Like, I don't know, click your mouse 10 times, run about 8 meters, you can slightly move your hand and press 2 buttons in 1 second. It will take me exactly 1 second to tell you about the sponsor of this video, don't quote me on that. But if you are tired of Skyblock being in the sky, how basic, am I right? Well, how about Skyblock in space? Well, SpaceDelta is an insane server with some truly innovative features that combine the typical widely loved feeling of Minecraft with a more RPG-esque game mode. At its core, SpaceDelta is a Skyblock server, however, as you play, you will see it's far more than that. This server brings some insane features that make it feel like it's more than just your run-of-the-mill Skyblock server, including crazy custom bosses that you can fight in an arena in space. How cool is that? That's not it, though. You can explore tons of events, like the Void, where you have to defeat waves of monsters and collect falling crate shipments. You can also spot ton of lore around the server with NPCs placed around the spawn that you can speak to, and even more stories on the website. One of my personal favorite features is the casino. Not only is absolutely insane build from the outside, it features games you may be familiar with like Crush and Roulette, as well as more. What makes SpaceDelta truly special though is a sense of community that comes along with the server. So if you want to check out the Skyblock server that is literally on another level, you can play it now at SpaceDelta.net on versions 1.15.2 and up, or just use link in the description since that also helps me out. Like I said, exactly 1 second. No, but all jokes aside, 1 second is actually longer than most people think it is, and we have an entire second to slightly move our mouse and press two buttons. And that's assuming you have level 100 monkey pet. Just to be clear, it's totally fine. If you don't, I'm just not sure what you will do with all the free time between using your ability every 2 seconds, I'm that serious. But anyway, now the only question that may come to your mind is how am I going to get that tremendous amount of saplings and whatever even is this thing in the first place? Well, as for saplings, you can just buy unlimited amount from the NPC next to the spawn. This is enchanted bone meal, works same as regular bone meal, but instead of a few tries, it takes just one. You can also buy it from NPC, the problem is that one player can only buy 10 stacks per day. The only other way is to trade it from the trade menu, but also 10 stacks per day, which is just dumb. If you ask me, I prepared a whole speech in my head how annoying it is to trade from the trade menu and how I was going to bypass that with the redstone contraption. But yeah, no, that's fine, I'm fine. Just to be clear, no, it isn't a problem to get an enchanted bone meal. Trust me, there is way more than enough people willing to take 100k for literally a second of work. Some of you may ask, okay, but isn't 100k for something that costs 1k a lot? No, you're gonna make 5 times as much money from it. You are losing nothing. Poor people get money, you get unlimited resources. Everyone is happy, except for me. That was sad. But anyway, as for method itself, it's so easy that I don't know why am I even here, to be honest. So I decided to make it even easier and faster. So first thing is to set up the items in your hotbar in the right order, but that's kinda obvious. Next is to keep the crosshair in the center of the four dirt blocks, so you can place the four saplings basically instantly. And finally, it's a server, there always gonna be a little bit of delay, but if you wanna go as fast as possible, you need to act like there is no delay, except there is delay. Basically, you don't want to wait for the server to display the actions you are doing and just keep going. I don't really know how to explain it. But either way, it may take some time to get used to, but after a while, it should become automatic. And after you implement all that, trust me, you can go fast with it. Only after a few minutes of practice, I was able to get below 1 second with one cycle, except it isn't exactly good, because it means my ability isn't ready yet. But in that case, I can always implement the rod strat for extra for a experience, and if I feel like I wanna sweat some more, but I really don't. Also, if anyone is wondering about the XP rate, the theoretical highest with the rod strat would be around 1.5 mil an hour, but the highest realistically achievable in a long run would be more like 1.23 mil. The highest without the rod strat would be about 1.15 mil, but more probable would be around 1 mil per hour. Also, a super lazy way with just an ocelot pet, where you have entire 2 seconds between using your ability, is still 750k an hour, and I must admit, I know little to nothing about the foraging, but I'm pretty sure you'd have to sweat pretty hard in the park to do same as the laziest option here. And yeah, that's pretty much it. It's so easy, it takes literally nothing to set up, and I'm sure people don't mind to refill their inventory every now and then. Well, too bad for them, because I'm gonna fix it anyway. So my idea was to build some kind of item cycler that will dispense saplings and bone meal near me, so as I am using them, it is instantly refilling my inventory, and the excess of items is automatically going back to the chest, so I built this. I am almost certain it isn't the best way to build it, but it's working first try, so I'm gonna take it. So this is where items get dispensed. Then the excess of the items is going back with the water stream to this. Yeah, I have no idea why is that a thing, but it looks cool, and then the items go back to the chest. Now the only thing I have to do is to fill the storage system, which depending on the size will last me for hours, days, or even forever if I'm not gonna use it. Yeah, I hate foraging. Although I can't believe I'm saying it, but this is low-key kind of satisfying. And as much it is convenient to have your inventory full at all time, I even less know why, in my opinion, it's even more addicting to do it without the item cycler. Like, I don't know, it's just the fact that you can see the items basically vaporizing from your inventory, but like I said, I have no idea. Also, I just wanna say this is just a basic idea, and there's way more things you can do with it. Like, there is this whole thing that you could probably utilize somehow with teleport pads or other people, I don't know. Also, one more disclaimer at the end, no, this doesn't discredit anything. Every method has its own pros and cons, and some people may just prefer forage in the park. And besides, I am still genuinely convinced it must be wrong somehow. I can clearly see it working, and yet I'm genuinely worried that everyone knows something that I don't, and this is just the dumbest thing ever. I mean, look at this, I'm literally placing saplings and using bone meal. This is the dumbest thing ever. And if that works, what is the point of this whole place then?